Hey, early birds, welcome back for another edition of Early Bird Reviews. This week I'm going to be reviewing Transporter 3 with Jason Statham, yeah, the English Bruce Willis. And unfortunately, Lewis can't be with us because we're experimenting new equipment, you know, for future reviews. And I promise we'll be back together again for the Punisher Warzone. Alright, moving on. So the review was pretty much like this. Much like its predecessors, the film thrives on astronomical action and editing, but lacks in depth when it comes down to feeling the movie. Stale and at times running on fumes from the original, the third installment is however nothing short of a great, well, transporter flick. Cars, explosions, and a shirtless Statham is really all you need when it comes down to making a good transporter movie. While I'll say proudly that the first film released back in 2002 was by far one of the most enjoyable car movies I've ever seen, I'll admit that the latest one does live up to the name with a few potholes in the road. It's brave, it's bold, and it's insecure. It seems that throughout the film, I felt as if I was watching some kid trying to outlive his father's shadows. I suppose it did feel a bit overachieving after its last disaster of Transporter 2. But if you get through the tight choking of having to watch more of the same stuff over again, you'll see a brighter side to Frank Martin's somewhat tedious maneuvers. One of the many things that really impressed me this time around was his outstanding truth that there is no place this guy can go. Honestly, he's been through water, boats, rooftops, bridges, and yet it seems his infinite appetite for one-up ass-kicking and beautiful driving skills never seem to be satisfied. One could argue, of course, they're pulling as much green out of the series as they possibly can, but really, can you truly ignore Statham's awesomeness? He's English's Bruce Willis, a European titan, a legend in his own, and yet there is still something wrong here. He may be able to pummel a dozen goons, but as the movie rides on its own cash cow, Statham is losing steam with his Frank. The action for most of the major actors dropped harder than a stick driving through a school zone. Statham seems stale and often dim-witted compared to his earlier portrayals of the character. Frank Martin simply didn't seem as if he even wanted to do another transporter. I was impressed with Olivier Megaton's helping as a director, and even awed at his attempt to stylize the original concept. He managed to combine a new-age feel to the action that was working already, but with this change comes sacrifice. The humor was lacking, making the audience feel stupid and repulsed through a series of mindless chuckles gritting through their teeth. Everyone who watched that movie knew what they were up for, but little did they know that they had a much better chance of connecting to the audience in an infomercial than in Transporter 3. With that aside, its true elements, its real elements, you know, the one that felt repetitive, now seems almost a grateful gift from above. The fight scenes and car chases are still what they are and are still crucial to the film as any other, and that's what really saved it. You'll yawn at bold attempts to take the Transporter series into a new horizons, but then you're swept back into the passenger seat as Frank does what he does best, fight and drive. Sure, it's pure fan service to both the guys and gals, but when in doubt, it matters not. There's even a small testimony to the Indiana Jones' remarkable godliness as he proves that men really can't do the most ridiculous things to cheat death. Yes, I'm saying it. He nuked the fridge. Might I not forget the nearly confusing subplots that really is so confusing. The interweave and muddle around each other that might make it possible to support a nice 3-hour flick about eco-friendly terrorists. Again with the greenies, what's the deal? But in a transporter movie, it doesn't really make the cut and will instead leave you scratching your sand going, huh? So leaving the theater afterwards, I was left with a familiar taste in my mouth besides the stale popcorn and flat soda. Satisfied and even relieved to know that the series may be coming to an end, maybe. I mean, having Frank turn into his own romantic, Statham might have dropped the ball on that one. I don't see any of the films in the near future or far, but I'll still announce my pride in the series. It took action to a new level, making it faster, more intense, and more Statham. A nice flick to the start of a Thanksgiving holiday. And the verdict for me is 6 out of 10. It's watchable, acceptable, but not outstanding. So I would say it's worth the ticket. But it's all on you guys. If you're a Statham fan, definitely watch it. Not so much, it's a good action film. But don't expect on buying the DVD either. So with that said, we'll see you next week for Punisher. Alright, see ya.